climate change is kind of the kicker in here, in that you need lots of moose and you need favorable environment for the ticks to be so abundant.
Pete Pekins, retired UNH professor of wildlife ecology, is concerned about a warming climate extending falls and springs and causing less snow, because that means the winter tick will thrive in a state that has a high-density moose population.
Winter has been delayed 2 to 4 weeks now for the last decade, and that spring comes earlier. Those conditions play to the advantage of the tick.
When ticks search for a host, it's called the questing season. And with warmer weather, it's getting longer.
Moose acquire larvae in the fall, and these larvae are in pods of hundreds of larvae together. So a moose doesn't get one tick. It gets hundreds at a time.
That's one big difference with the winter tick versus other ticks. They quest in clusters instead of one by one. A study conducted from 2014 to 2016 for moose across parts of Maine and northern New Hampshire found a 70% calf mortality rate due to winter tick infestation.
There's nothing sadder than looking at these calf mortalities. I mean, these animals are literally being drained of life.
These death rates are unprecedented, and as many as 50 to 100,000 ticks have been found on a single calf.
That adult female is basically the size of a medium-sized grape. And she's that big because she's engorged with blood. So 50,000 on that one calf. And so when you run the math, its entire bloodline is gone in 2 weeks. And nothing can survive.
The winter tick has been around a long time, but has only started causing a problem for the moose population in recent years, a big factor being the changing, more favorable environment.
We've seen larvae on the landscape in December. And it's not a coincidence, the following year we had really high calf mortality. That is climate change. We don't see a solution other than reduced moose density, which effectively reduces tick density because it's a single host parasite system.
Now, that may seem counterintuitive, but it could mean healthier moose in the long run.